tutorial, I am going to make a special design, and I want to use belt animation. And for this, I have made a base. It is 100 by 100 rectangle, or I have written only draw a line with 100 length and 25 to the right, and I have made a extrude of that one. I have used solid, and I have given thickness as 5 millimeter. And exit the sketch, and I have draw 4 circles with diameter 10, and one of them 20 from the right side, and another one 20 from bottom, and another also 20 from bottom and 20 from left side, and another in the middle. And I have made 2 rolls. I have made a revolve. I have sketched a part like that with a 12 millimeter length and 10 millimeter height, 2 millimeter at right, 2 millimeter down, 4 millimeter to the right, 2 millimeter up, and 2 millimeter right. And I have made it, and in revolve I have used through the x coordinate system, okay. And I have made a hole. I have made a hole, and use pattern. The same thing, I have done another roll, and I have made it as a half millimeter, half size that the first roll, and I have 1 millimeter this edges, 1 millimeter down, and 2 millimeter that dimension, and 4 millimeter height, and 6 millimeter length. And the hole I want to make it is 5 millimeter in radius, and I use OCO, and in revolve also I have made it through x coordinate, and I have made a hole, and I have made a pattern. Now I am going to make assembly and call it belt. And I am going to select the base, and I am going to mate the part coordinate system to the assembly coordinate system. Rotate, Now I am going to take the roll and I am going to use pin. That face to that face and use that face to that face to get a fully constrained uko. I'm going to draw and it's rotating. Okay, I am going to add again roll and I am going to make the same pin between this face and this face and I am going to select that face mate, uko. I am going to drag and it's rotating. Close. Now I am going to add again roll uko. Now I'm going to select pin and select that face to that face and select that face that face. Uko. I am going to use drag again and it's rotating free. I am going to add roll 2 and I am going to use pin again between that surface and that surface and select that face to that face. Uko. I am going to use drag that edge and it's rotating free. Uko. Close. To see better, I am going to select the roll 1 and I am going to make it as blue. I am going to select the second one and make it green. The third one, I am making it yellow. And the last one, I am going to make it as gold. This one, or maybe this one. Okay. Now I am going in application mechanism, and I am going to select the belt icon. And I am selecting that face, keep control key, that face, keep control key, that face, and use that one, right click, flip belt, and then keep control key and use that face and again make it flip the belt. Now it is rotating in that shape. Okay, I accept it and I am going to make it drag. When I rotate, all the other roll rotates too. This is what I want. And I am going to select that one and use I'm going inside the connection belt, select over the belt, right click and use make part and accept as the part 3 and copy from existing, and it is okay. I accept it. Now I am going to this one. Now I am going again because it wasn't make part. Part 3 was it? Okay, there's an accent. Part 4. As default, and it is fully constrained, and select OK. I am going back to standard, and I am going to insert sweep. Okay, I must select that part and use activate, and I am going on the insert step protrusion and select trajectory and select one by one and select that arc, keep control key, that line, that arc, that line, that arc, that line, that arc, and that line. OK, done. Accept the arrow and accept this one, and now I must draw a section. I am going to use projection. OK, close, and I am going to select the midpoint of that one to the midpoint of that one and deselect and use trim that one and that one, deselect and accept. Now I am going to use preview. It's perfectly, as you see, our belt is designed, and go through as we wished. Now I am going back to mechanism, and I have all these, and I am going to hide it. No, unhide. It's okay, it can stay there. I am going to use servo motor and motion axis. I am going to select that one over the little roller, and on the profile I use velocity and I use 20, apply OK, and I am going to make a kinematic and make it as 50 with 2 as ratio and use run. As you see, all of them rotates. all of them rotates. Uko, I am going under callback. I am going to select, and I am going to select the reward, and I am going to increase the speed, and I am going to see, instead of make it two servo motor, I am going to make it one, and now it is rotating backwards. Now it rotating backwards. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.